Space exploration has been one of the most fascinating topics in science and technology for centuries. Human exploration of space has been limited by the biological constraints of the human body, particularly during long-distance space travel. With the advent of CRISPR-Cas9 technology, scientists are now exploring the possibility of using gene editing to modify human genetics for long-distance space travel.
So the way the CRISPR technology works is by the action of a protein called Cas9 that functions like a molecular scalpel for DNA.
The CRISPR-Cas9 system has an amazing ability to recognize a particular DNA sequence in a cell that may be malfunctioning, and then disable it by cutting the DNA. We call this gene editing, and we can use it to disable or repair a mutated part of the gene, which may be causing disease. For Cas9 to find the malfunctioning DNA, we attach it to an RNA sequence that matches the DNA sequence we want to edit. Then we put this RNA-Cas9 combination into the cell. It finds the mutant DNA and uses a chemical reaction to cut the DNA strand right at the spot where it's malfunctioning. After that, we can sometimes insert the correct version of the gene for the cell to work properly again.
The biggest challenge that humans face in space is radiation, especially during long-distance space travel. The human body isn't equipped to handle the high levels of radiation present in space. Here on Earth, it's our planet's atmosphere and magnetic field that protect us from the harmful radiation of the sun and other cosmic sources. However, in space, astronauts are exposed to high levels of radiation, which can cause cancer, damage the immune system, and affect cognitive function. One way to mitigate this risk is by using CRISPR to modify genes responsible for repairing DNA damage caused by radiation and to increase radiation resistance. Scientists have identified certain genes that are responsible for repairing DNA damage caused by radiation. For example, the gene ATM, ataxia telangiectasia mutated, is responsible for detecting and repairing DNA damage caused by radiation. By using CRISPR, scientists could modify this gene to enhance its functionality and increase the body's ability to repair DNA damage. Another gene, TP53, is also involved in repairing DNA damage caused by radiation. By modifying this gene, scientists could increase the body's ability to repair DNA damage and reduce the risk of cancer. This would enable astronauts to withstand harmful radiation levels during long-distance space travel. The second challenge is the effects of prolonged space travel on the human body. Long-distance space travel can lead to muscle atrophy, bone loss, and other health issues due to the lack of gravity. By using CRISPR, scientists could modify genes responsible for muscle and bone growth to counteract the effects of prolonged space travel. One example is the gene myostatin, which is responsible for regulating muscle growth. By modifying this gene, scientists could increase muscle growth and reduce muscle atrophy. Similarly, the gene SOST is responsible for regulating bone growth. By modifying this gene, scientists could increase bone growth and reduce bone loss. These modifications would ensure that astronauts remain healthy and physically fit during extended missions in space. Another potential application of CRISPR is in the development of new sensory systems for humans. The human body has 5 senses, but in space, it's essential to have additional sensory capabilities to adapt to the unique environment. By using CRISPR to modify the human genome, scientists could potentially develop new sensory systems, such as the ability to detect radiation levels, magnetic fields, and other environmental factors. This technology could also enhance our existing senses. For example, the gene TMC1 is responsible for hearing. By modifying this gene, scientists could potentially develop the ability to detect sounds outside of the human hearing range. Similarly, the gene VGLUT2 is responsible for detecting taste. By modifying this gene, scientists could potentially develop the ability to taste new flavors and detect toxins. These sensory modifications would enable astronauts to better navigate and survive in space. Moreover, CRISPR could be used to enhance the immune system of astronauts. During long-distance space travel, the immune system is weakened, making astronauts susceptible to infections and diseases. The gene CCR5 is involved in the immune system's response to infections. By modifying this gene, scientists could potentially enhance the immune system's ability to fight infections and diseases. This would ensure that astronauts remain healthy and protected during their missions. CRISPR has the potential to revolutionize long-distance space travel by modifying the human genome to overcome the biological limitations of the human body in space. By enhancing radiation resistance, developing new sensory systems, increasing bone and muscle growth, and improving the immune system, CRISPR could make long-distance space travel safer and more feasible. But keep in mind that most of this research has been done on mice, and that gene editing in humans is still a relatively new and controversial field. There are many ethical considerations and safety concerns that need to be addressed before any human gene editing can be performed. However, the potential is real and cannot be ignored. With further research and development, CRISPR could potentially make long-distance space travel safer and more feasible. Don't forget to watch the video on the right and subscribe. Thanks for being part of Cosmoknowledge.